Western University of Health Sciences exists to prepare innovative, progressive, and humanistic professionals who ultimately enhance health, save lives, and reduce suffering.
To teach, to heal, together, Western University of Health Sciences. Today, hundreds of you have gathered to watch your loved ones take their first step into the health professions. Convocation marks the official launch of their studies at the College of Osteopathic Medicine of the Pacific Northwest. Later, during our white coat ceremony, you will see them put on white clinical jackets to signify entrance into the field of osteopathic medicine. Yes, it is a day of symbolism and pageantry that signals a new academic year at WesternU, the 41st year for this university, whose origins date back to 1977 with the founding of its first college, the College of Osteopathic Medicine of the Pacific. From renovated storefront buildings in downtown Pomona, California, the founders set forth on a mission to prepare primary care physicians to meet healthcare needs in the Western United States. Under the leadership of Dr. Philip Pomerantz, our long-serving first president, 36 students enrolled in the charter class, which graduated in 1982. Soon, the small medical school expanded its campus to serve the medical needs of the surrounding Pomona Valley, as well as the educational needs of the nation's health sciences professions. In 1996, the college was restructured as Western University of Health Sciences and began welcoming several new colleges, all committed to the founding principle of humanism, with a total of 9 graduate colleges offering more than 20 degrees. WesternU has become the most comprehensive health sciences institution in the country. A second campus opened in 2011 here in Lebanon, Oregon, to address critical healthcare needs in the Pacific Northwest. And in 2016, the university named its second permanent president, Dr. Daniel R. Wilson. Today, nearly 4,000 students attend WesternU on 2 campuses, including over 100 incoming students with us here today. New students in the audience, are you ready to begin your journey? Are you excited? Do you wish a former student could just tell you how to succeed in medical school? Before you get started on your journey, listen to these words of advice from a few recent graduates of Comp Northwest, beginning with the most fundamental of all, learn all that you can.
Enjoy every day and keep an open mind. You'll have a lot of great learning experiences.
It's not about the knowledge you gain, but the habits you form that make learning possible.
Do not ever discredit the need for information, whether it be from a patient, a professor, a lecturer, or a classmate. You never know when you will need even the smallest tidbit of knowledge. Learn it right and learn it completely the first time, and it will pay off a million times over.
But while you're studying hard, former students say, take time to take care of yourself.
Please take care of yourselves during medical school. Eat right, sleep well, and exercise, and the rest will come easy.
Try to get 8 hours of sleep every night. Okay, maybe 7.
Listen to yourself. If you need a break, it's okay to take one.
Get outside and explore the wonders of Oregon. Don't forget to take care of yourself.
But none of this works unless you keep a positive attitude.
Attitude is everything. You are your only limit, and you can achieve amazing things.
Expect to struggle, learn to overcome.
Guys, medical school is really what you make of it. It can be the ugly monster under the bed that eats you up, spits you out, or it could be a wonderful time where you form friends and family, so enjoy it.
Find what excites you and intentionally keep it alive.
Hang in there, the end is worth it.
On behalf of WesternU's Academic Senate and our more than 400 faculty, I'd like to offer a word of advice for incoming students from a faculty perspective. Remember, You were each carefully selected from among a very large pool of applicants to study, learn, and discover with faculty who will be your instructors, mentors, and future colleagues. Be an active participant in your education experience. Seize upon the opportunities to interact and engage with your faculty. That interaction begins today, symbolically with the white coat ceremony, where faculty place white coats over the shoulders of incoming students. Faculty are honored to participate in this event and gratified to see the same students grow through the years from learners to graduates to full-fledged healthcare professionals.
Throughout much of the world, the doctor's white coat is recognized as a symbol of healing, better known even than the doctor's bag or stethoscope. But did you know, for centuries, doctors wore black clothing when visiting the sick at home or attending patients close to death? The change from black to white happened in the late 1800s, about the time Dr. Andrew Taylor Still, seen here in traditional black clothing, was first introducing his innovative philosophy of osteopathic medicine to America. Notice how in this painting by Thomas Eakins from 1875, the doctors and students are wearing black as they perform an operation on a young man. While in this painting by the same artist just a few years later, doctors and nurses are portrayed wearing white. It's because major scientific discoveries were revolutionizing medicine at this time, such as Joseph Lister's study of bacterial contamination, and white had come to symbolize the cleanliness of a scientific environment. Since then, white coats have been worn by doctors to promote a trusting relationship between doctor and patient. It was only a matter of time before students entering the health professions would begin to be cloaked in white coats at the outset of their studies, typically in short clinical jackets rather than full-length doctor's coats, in keeping with the tradition that the longer the coat, the higher the medical status and experience of its wearer. In 1993, the nation's first white coat ceremony was conducted at Columbia University, thanks to the Arnold P. Gold Foundation. And just 4 years later, in 1997, the first white coat ceremony at WesternU. Now, each year, faculty on both Pomona and Lebanon campuses place white coats on students' shoulders in front of family and friends, entrusting them to carry on the tradition of the health profession. Today, you are one of those students, and the excitement you feel this morning is part of a long-cherished tradition at WesternU.
To all of you putting on your first white coats this morning, students proudly embarking on your medical careers, think of today as a rite of passage. Today, you receive a short coat to remind you of your responsibilities as a healer from the first day of your education. One day, you hope to wear a full-length doctor's coat when you graduate as a DO. We applaud you as you pledge yourselves to 4 years of study at the College of Osteopathic Medicine of the Pacific, to the humanistic environment at Western University of Health Sciences, and to the evolving field of osteopathic medicine. We support you on your journey.
Greetings to you all. We look forward to seeing you progress in your great new adventure.
We could not be more pleased you are now part of our WesternU family. All of us are here to help you succeed.
The new student you are today will grow into the health science professional you will be tomorrow. You will make the world a better place, the WesternU way, with humanistic science as the basis of compassionate care. We wish you every success.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as we meet the people who will guide your loved ones on their journey, the faculty, administration, and board of trustees. Dr. Paula M. Crone, Dean of the College of Osteopathic Medicine of the Pacific Northwest, and the President of Western University of Health Sciences, Dr. Daniel R. Wilson. Thank you.
Health Sciences, Dr. Daniel R. Wilson. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome. Praise in 3D, who will sing our national anthem.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Reverend Ted Boatsman, who will offer today's invocation.
Good morning. If you would join me in prayer, please. I would say, Lord, we, these men and women who are present here today, are on a journey to create not only a life and profession for themselves, but a legacy for others to follow, all within their specific fields of study. We would ask that your guidance will be given to all those who embarked on this journey, the most remarkable endeavor of their lives, that your blessings would be on those who would guide their progress from day to day and bless those who have made it possible for them to be here. The Hippocratic Oath would ask them to never do harm. Jesus would have them to do more than that. He would ask them to be the salt and the light, to master the art of serving others. Thomas Jefferson said, in matters of fashion, swim with the current. In matters of conscience, stand like a rock. Lord, we would ask that you would help these to stand firm for the important things in life. And Father, help those who are gathered here today to learn the art of healing and to master the art of serving others and to stand for truth, honesty, and integrity. Amen. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of Western University of Health Sciences, Dr. Daniel R. Wilson.
Please be seated. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, Dean Crone, the mayor, distinguished guests, trustees, advancement board, Lebanon community, our faculty, staff, the parents, and especially the new class of 2022. It is my pleasure to welcome you to this, the convocation and white coat ceremony of the College of Osteopathic Medicine of the Pacific Northwest of Western University of Health Sciences. Each year at this time, it is the tradition of the university to have a welcome convocation to honor all matriculants and officially open the academic year. 8 days from today, more than 1,000 of your fellow first-year students in 9 colleges and 21 degree programs will participate in a similar ceremony for the WesternU campus in Pomona, California. So you have a small head start on them. And I'm honored to be with you today for these ceremonies. But again, let me extend a special welcome to our incoming students, the College of Osteopathic Medicine of the Pacific Northwest incoming class, the future of medicine. I want to assure each and every one of you, we are all in this together. A family-like culture has ever been and will forever be a hallmark of WesternU. The staff and faculty of WesternU are committed to your success and will do everything possible to help you on your journey through school and beyond. We are here for you. Of that you can be sure. Now I would like to introduce the chairman of our Board of Trustees, Dr. Richard Bond, who, by the way, is the very first graduate in the 1982 charter class of the College of Osteopathic Medicine of the Pacific. Dr. Bond will bring greetings from the board. As he comes forward, will all members of the Advancement Board who are present here today please stand and be recognized.
Thank you, Dr. Wilson, friends, WesternU family, and especially the Comp Northwest class of 2022? My goodness. It is my honor and privilege, speaking for the Board of Trustees, to offer each of you our sincere greetings. The trustees and I want you to know that osteopathic medicine is deeply rooted in the Northwest, and indeed many of the towns and settlements are served by DOs, and more will be. Here this week, you entering students will glimpse the long road that will shape your careers. I hope you also keep in mind the impact those careers will have on the thousands of patients you are training to serve, people you will trust and only on you, rely on you. I see two challenges that you will face. The first, you will undoubtedly be surprised, perhaps overwhelmed, by the breadth and depth of the material you will be exposed to absorb in the next 4 years. You can do it. The second challenge is the uncharted wilderness of healthcare reform. I doubt that anyone here can predict what the landscape will look like when you graduate in 2022. I simply advise you to keep informed and make the best choice you can with the data you have, and concentrate on giving your patients scientifically competent and humanistic care. In my professional career, I've kept a guiding principle. If you take care of your patients will see that you're taken care of too. Later today, you will put on your white coats. When you stick your arms into these white sleeves, I hope you'll be committing yourself to a life dedicated to a higher achievement. Remember, those white coats are a symbol of your attitude and sincerity. It is a purpose of your teachers, the staff, the administration, and we trustees to fill them with skill and knowledge and humanism, to provide you with a value far greater than a certificate or diploma. I've never been more confident or enthusiastic about entering students achieving value and success beyond your fondest dreams. If you didn't have the right stuff, we wouldn't have chosen you. You were chosen carefully as carefully as you've chosen us, as you've chosen us. Everyone here has a stake in your success. Each of you and each of us have a role of responsibilities. Let's get to it. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Bond, for your wise words on this day of great happiness and fine prospects. For our entering students, a day like this must have been a long-held dream. Your pursuit of this dream involved hard work and sacrifice so that today the dream could begin to become a goal. But as the old adage holds, a dream is just a dream. A goal is a dream with a plan and a deadline. The plan starts today, and the deadline is a scant few years' time that will fly by faster than you can imagine. You should know that WesternU is part of a community here in Lebanon that has enthusiastically given its support to our university and its students from the earliest stages. The people of Lebanon and the great state of Oregon have worked side by side with us to make this dream of this school a reality. We could not have come this far without them. So it is in that spirit of dreaming and striving that I welcome all of you today. And now I would like to welcome our Provost and Chief Operating Officer, Dr. Googlechuck, to give us a review of substantial information.
Thank you, Mr. President. And good morning, students, faculty, staff, trustees, alumni, parents, and distinguished guests. Today, Western University of Health Sciences is among the most comprehensive academic healthcare centers in the nation, having grown to this position in a brief 40 years. In order for you to grasp the full impact of the remarkable history, tradition, and spirit of Western University of Health Sciences, listen to how others have described the university. Pioneering, distinctive, innovative, humanistic, visionary. These powerful words embody the fundamental nature of WesternU. As mentioned earlier, Comp Northwest does not exist in isolation, but is a vital part of the larger Western University family, and is but one of the most recent expressions of WesternU's remarkable growth. In 1977, the university was established as the College of Osteopathic Medicine of the Pacific, COMP, by a daring and resolute group of trailblazers under the leadership of a visionary founding president. COMP started in very humble space and facilities that were originally a shopping mall in downtown Pomona, California. However, over the next 20 years, three colleges, Allied Health Professions, and which is has recently been named at the start of this year, the College of Health Sciences, and Pharmacy, and Graduate Nursing was added, and a university with four health professions colleges was born. A College of Veterinary Medicine was formed in 1998. Amazingly, four more colleges were added in just the last 10 years, Dentistry, Optometry, Podiatric Medicine, and Graduate Biomedical Sciences, bringing us to our current nine colleges and two campus locations, Pomona, California, and Lebanon, Oregon. So today, we find WesternU to be a thriving health sciences university, including a blossoming research and patient care enterprise that supports our academic mission. Jointly, the college deans and faculty support our mission to produce, in a humanistic tradition, healthcare professionals and biomedical knowledge that will enhance and extend the quality of life in our communities. The university is fast becoming a premier academic health center, a center that is redefining the model for health sciences education, if not the delivery of healthcare itself. WesternU continues to set the pace for healthcare innovation through its evolving model interprofessional education program, a groundbreaking curriculum where students from all our health professional programs learn to function as a team. We are also exploring innovations in health sciences education, including the use of mobile apps and our virtual anatomy initiatives. So, to our incoming students, As future WesternU graduates, you will understand and appreciate what other health professionals outside your own discipline really do, shattering the siloed system of care in this country. And as tomorrow's leaders, you will have the skills to provide collaborative care and to be the catalyst to fix our broken healthcare system, one patient at a time. The WesternU legacy continues with you, the best, the brightest, and the newest additions to the WesternU family. Carry close to your hearts the tenets of our underlying institutional values, the discipline of learning, the art of caring, and the spirit of healing. We celebrate the start of this new academic year and your journey to join a new generation of healers, a new generation of change agents, and a new generation of leaders who in the future will also be described as pioneering, distinctive, innovative, humanistic, and visionary. Again, welcome students, and now it's time for you to start blazing your own trails. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Googlechuck, for your fine summary. Now I would like to ask Dean Crone to come to the podium to introduce our keynote speaker.
It is my pleasure to introduce a member of our senior leadership team at Comp Northwest as today's convocation speaker, Dr. Maribel Fernandez-Paul. Dr. Fernandez-Paul completed her undergraduate and master's degrees in biochemistry and molecular biology from the University of Bombay, completed her doctoral graduate studies doing work on cytoplasmic glycoproteins at the Epley Institute for Cancer Research, and obtained her doctorate in higher education leadership and administration at the University of St. Thomas in Minnesota. She worked at the Mayo Clinic before moving to Oregon, where she was the co-founder of the Etihad Center at Oregon State University. She is married to Dr. Adam Paul, a pediatrician in Albany, and is mother to Liam and Aiden. She is a passionate and dedicated educator, relentless advocate for our students, and a role model to all. Our Assistant Dean of Student Affairs, Dr. Maribel Fernandez-Paul.
Good morning, President and Mrs. Wilson, WesternU Board of Trustees, Provost Googlechuck, Dean's Advisory Board members, Dean Crone, community members, faculty, staff, family and friends of our students, and the stars of the day, student doctors of the class of 2022. It is my honor today to address you all on this momentous occasion of WesternU's first convocation and white coat ceremony for the new academic year. I have spent the greater part of this week getting to know each member of this exemplary group of student doctors. And ladies and gentlemen, I am delighted to share with you all that these student doctors gathered here before you today are among the best and the brightest of our future healers. My dear student doctors, you have patiently listened to countless talks from me and many of my colleagues since Monday. Please allow me to address you one last time this week, and I promise to keep it short. So for no particular reason, except maybe to spy on you all, I like to periodically read posts on a website called studentdoctor.net. You all know what I'm referring to, yes? Yes. On one of those threads, I stumbled on a rather entertaining discussion on the topic of metaphors for medical school. Some metaphors I immediately connected with, some took me a few minutes to understand, and others I will probably need your help in deciphering. Here are some examples of those metaphors. Medical school is like a roller coaster ride? Absolutely. Medical school is about survival of the fittest. Agreed. Medical school is like trying to eat an elephant in a day. Strange, but I can see that. Medical school is like trying to drink from a fire hose. Yes? Eating 20 pancakes a day? Trying to wash down 20 pancakes a day by drinking from a fire hose. And here is the most bizarre one of all. Medical school is like trying to grease a three-legged cow. I did not make that up. It came from studentdoctor.net. I had the good fortune to meet almost all of you on interview day when I shared with you that I believe that medical school is like a marathon, not a sprint. I like the marathon metaphor for many reasons, primarily because marathoners, unlike sprinters, are largely in competition with themselves, not with others. You are here on this great day about to receive your white coats in a ceremony that will formally accept you into a very elite group of student doctors at WesternU, Oregon. You were selected after very close review by a tough group of us on the admissions committee and the admissions department. 4,000 students applied, and we invited the best 107. You made the cut of 4,000 applicants, who, by the way, were not so shabby themselves. So believe me when I say, you belong, you are worthy, and you are home. So when you receive your scores on your exams, rather than compare yours with your classmates, ask yourself if you improved your performance on the last exam, whether you implemented the advice your tutor or your advisor gave you, and what, if anything, can you do to fare better on the next exam or quiz. Much like a marathon, medical school is not so much about getting to the finish line first as it is about getting to the finish line intact in body, soul, and mind. Now, I'd like to continue using this marathon metaphor and share some pearls of wisdom that I believe will help you make the best of the next 4 years. First, no matter how naturally talented you are, you must invest in great amounts of time and effort to succeed in medical school. The amount of material and the speed at which it will be delivered to you is much like the fire hose that your fellow medical students have so wisely described on studentdoctor.net. So keeping with the two most interesting metaphors from studentdoctor.net, imagine eating an elephant in one sitting, or trying to grease a three-legged cow if the cow and you had never met before. But you could meet those goals if you diligently took small bites of that elephant every day, or gradually earned the trust of the cow from when it was a young calf. Second, know that every day is different. Some days, a 5-mile uphill hike will feel easy. Other days, a flat mile will feel impossible. Be aware of your stimuli. Learn to recognize your responses. Some topics that you have had in undergraduate classes may allow you to get away with lesser study time. Some professors' teaching styles will align with your learning styles. Others, not so much. A family member's health, conflict with a classmate, tragedies in the community and the country will all affect how much distance you will cover on your marathon at any given time. It is impossible for anyone to give 100% of the time. Know when it's best for you to take some time off, maybe an hour, maybe a day, maybe a week, and maybe even a year. Third, no matter how hard you work and how prepared you are, life will happen, and your hard work will not always result in proportional success. Unlike sprinters, marathoners often find themselves at the mercy of circumstances outside of their control. The weather, treacherous terrain, traffic conditions are all contributing factors that affect their performance. Successful marathoners know that looking to their coaches for direction and motivation is a great strategy to maneuver around those stumbling blocks. When you run into those barriers on your marathon through medical school, lean on your support system. The several student services offices at WesternU, such as my office, your advisor, your mentors, your professors, along with your personal network of classmates, friends, and family members, can help you navigate your marathon through the roughest terrain. It is important that you invest time and effort early on in medical school to build those relationships and know who to lean on when the need arises. Fourth, you may have all heard the story illustrated by American educator, author, and leadership guru Stephen Covey about a workshop facilitator who put a dozen fist-sized rocks into a jar. Then when his students thought he couldn't add any more, he dumped some gravel in and shook the jar, causing the gravel to work themselves into the spaces between the rocks. When they thought the jar was full, he added sand, which slipped into the spaces left between the rocks and the gravel. And then he added a pitcher of water. His wide-eyed students thought he was trying to prove to them that no matter how full your schedule is, if you really, really try hard, you can always fit things into your schedule. No, said the speaker, that's not the point. The truth this illustration teaches us, is if you don't put those big rocks in first, instead filled your jar with gravel and sand and water, you will never fit those rocks in at all. On this marathon that is medical school, you'll need to figure out for yourself what is truly important to you. In other words, you will need to know for sure what your big rocks truly are. What can you let go of or postpone to lighten your medical school journey and help keep you focused on what is truly important to you? What do you need to make sure to take with you on this journey? What do you absolutely have to protect to keep intact and whole when you cross that finish line come spring of 2022? Relationships with your family? Your health? Identify your big rocks now. Then remember to hold on tight to them as you begin the journey in exactly 10 days from today. And my last piece of advice to you, find a cause bigger than your own personal success. Even though your goal is to finish medical school, find a way to connect that goal to your goal to something bigger and farther reaching than yourself. There is a reason charity marathons are one of the most successful ways to involve people in fundraising. That finish line to a runner means more than just the completion of a race. It signifies their contribution to a greater cause, whether it's inching towards a cure for ALS or Alzheimer's or funding for your local Boys and Girls programs. So find your greater cause as you begin this medical school marathon. On days when you are tempted to give up, that greater cause will motivate you to get up, dust your knees, and get back on your run. And above all, never forget that at the end of your medical education will be the health and wellness of each of your patients. I will end with a quote by marathon blogger Lori Culnane that I think says it beautifully. Everything you ever wanted to know about yourself, you can learn in 26.2 miles. I wish you the very best as you set out on this great adventure of learning and discovery that is medical school.
Thank you, Dr. Fernandez-Paul, for those words of vision and insight. It occurs to me that I was a sprinter in high school, but I somehow made it through medical school. Let me reiterate how today's activities are all designed for one overriding end, to warmly welcome you into the WesternU family. You've begun to learn about the university philosophy, which is quite unique. I'm sure you have come to know that you are truly meant to be here. Events today are part of a week of orientation activities. Our new students have made friends, found their way around campus, gotten settled into residences. But convocation is only one half of formalities taking place today. The other is the white coat ceremony immediately following this. And as we begin the academic year, I would like to recognize and honor the heart and soul of any university, our marvelous faculty. The greatest gift faculty can give students is to serve as exemplary role models. I ask our faculty to stand and be recognized. I would also like to recognize the hard work and creativity of the College of Osteopathic Medicine of the Pacific Northwest Convocation Planning Team under the leadership of our speaker, Dr. Maribel Fernandez-Paul, and also the support of the University Public Affairs Department, the One Source Strategy Group, and our outstanding staff. At this point, I'd like to turn the program over to Dean Crone, who will lead our annual white coat ceremony.
Thank you, President Wilson. And welcome Provost Googlechuck, Dr. Bond, Dr. Allen, and members of our Comp Northwest Advisory Board. As you can already tell, today is a big deal for our students. We are here to celebrate these 107 future physicians as they receive their first white coat and take the Osteopathic Pledge of Commitment. The white coat ceremony is a rite of passage, signifying the importance of the life's work our students are about to embrace. It is an honor to stand before this audience as the class of 2022 celebrates this milestone on their path to becoming a physician. I especially wish to welcome their proud parents, their families, and their friends. It's because of your love, your support, and your sacrifice that your student is here today. I wish to thank all of our supporters, those who have helped lay a foundation of education and excellence that we proudly stand upon at WesternU. Special dignitaries in the audience today, including Mayor Paul Aziz, City Council President Bob Elliott, Linn County Commissioner Will Tucker, and key supporters Carol and John Dinges and Mrs. Thelma Toombs. Our thanks for all that you do. As we stand here today, we acknowledge the first graduates from Comp Northwest, our class of 2015. Many of them have completed their residency this year and are now returning to Oregon and the Pacific Northwest to begin their careers. Today, we are honored to have one of those graduates with us, Dr. Cody Seeley, who starts his practice in Roseburg later this month. We could have a round of applause for Dr. Seeley. My heartfelt thank you to all of the unsung heroes in our audience who tirelessly help to ensure our students succeed and help make Comp Northwest the very special place that it is, and have helped to grow it into WesternU, Oregon. I also want to acknowledge the giants that have come before us who passed away this last year. WesternU President Emeritus Philip Pomerantz, former Lebanon Mayor Ken Toom, Comp Faculty Leader Dr. Jim May, former Comp Dean and Osteopathic Leader Dr. Don Kirpin, alumni Dr. Sean Wyman and Dr. John Fong, and Comp Northwest Professor Michelle Havorka. All of them made a tremendous impact on all of us and are missed. I also want to welcome the newest members of our faculty to Comp Northwest WesternU, Oregon, Dr. Edie Sperling and Dr. Mandy Hudson. Let's have a round of applause for our newest faculty members. And I want to take a moment to recognize and thank a special sponsor, the Osteopathic Physicians and Surgeons of Oregon, for the white coats our students are proudly wearing or will be wearing shortly, and for sponsoring the Tools of the Trade program. OPSO, the Osteopathic Physicians and Surgeons of Oregon, is represented today by Mr. David Walls, the Executive Director. Thank you, Mr. Walls. And a special thanks to Pastor Boatsman for once again sharing his church with us and making us feel at home here, and for providing today's invocation. Mary Carter, representing the Lebanon Chamber of Commerce, and the Strawberrians, who are assisting us today, as they do throughout the year at every single event that we do. And the Domini brothers, that once again brought tears to my eyes for their beautiful rendition of the national anthem. And our WesternU faculty and staff from both campuses who are represented on the stage and throughout the audience. This team that makes all things possible. This dedicated team is here today because of our students and for your future patients. One of the reasons that Comp Northwest is so successful is because of the support of our Lebanon community. This deserves special note. I truly believe that we are training a better future physician because of our many community partnerships. Opportunities to participate and partner, such as Mini Medical School, Kindergarten University, Literacy Day, Lebanon Health Career Ladders, and the other over 400 outreach and partnerships our students, faculty, and staff have the privilege to participate in every single year. These community partnerships and all they represent deserve a round of applause as well. Western University of Health Sciences takes its responsibility of educating our future physicians seriously and strives to do so with the highest of standards. We recognize that it is not only a new era for medical education, but is one filled with tremendous expectations. We know that this next generation of physician will lead and will transform healthcare. And we expect them to do so while still maintaining their compassion, their empathy, and their servant hearts. This is also an era where, finally, managing health and wellness is as important as managing disease. Students, it is an exciting time to be a medical student. More so than ever, your generation, you, are going to be helping to shape the future of medicine and the way our patients are taken care of. Let me tell you about this class of 2022. They are a very high-achieving and impressive group of young women and men. They come to Comp Northwest from all corners of this country. 58 are from the Northwest, but both coasts and the states in between are represented. Several were born overseas, including China, the Ukraine, Japan, South Korea, Ireland, and Greece. The average age is 25. 13 already have a master's degree. This class includes accountants, teachers, a ski patrol member, a flight paramedic, a physician assistant, as well as athletes and rodeo queens. One student read every Agatha Christie book in 1 year. Another is a two-time Ironman. Many of you play instruments. One makes wine. The members of this class have already distinguished themselves for their humanitarian work in countries such as Costa Rica, Uganda, Taiwan, and Bangladesh. 107 of you were chosen from over 4,000 applications and 350 interviews to fill these seats. You were chosen with great care and with a sincere belief that we would welcome you into our osteopathic profession in the future and entrust our lives into your hands in later years. You are an impressive group of young men and women, but don't let that go to your heads. We won't let you. You are about to begin on the most difficult and humbling stage of your education to date. Students, today, you officially begin your journey to becoming an osteopathic physician. You were selected carefully, thoughtfully, and intentionally. You represent the future of medicine. If you've not gotten the message yet, we have very high hopes and expectations for you, but not any greater than those expectations of your future patients. With the symbolism of your white coat, your newly purchased stethoscope, and the black doctor bags, You are about to begin on a career path unlike any other. You have chosen a life of dedication and one of service. You will take a pledge of commitment today and the osteopathic oath in 4 short years. In exchange, you are accorded a special place in our society. Use this privilege carefully, respectfully, and wisely. Use it to be healers, not just doctors. Use it to be leaders in your communities, and always, always use it to be champions of your patients. With your medical education comes great responsibility. Your patients will be putting their trust and their lives in your hands. This responsibility must be held sacred. As your dean, I pass on to you my dean's challenge. And in 4 short years, this dean's challenge will become my dean's charge when you graduate. Today, I challenge you. I challenge you to work hard to learn all that you can, although it will never seem like it's enough. I challenge you to be courageous and to learn to practice medicine with purpose, passion, and skill, to use your head, your hands, and your heart, and to listen and to always care. I challenge you to always strive for excellence and to keep your standards set at the highest of levels. I challenge you to not only stand on the shoulders of the giants that come before you, to become that giant yourself for those that follow behind. I challenge you to be extraordinary, to be exceptional, and to settle for nothing less. And you know what's coming next. I challenge each and every one of you to always remember the end of every action, every thought, and every deed, there is your patient. Never forget that. Your osteopathic medical education will serve you well. Welcome to Western University of Health Sciences, College of Osteopathic Medicine of the Pacific Northwest, and welcome to the osteopathic family and to medical school. Class of 2022. You can do it. I now have the distinct pleasure of welcoming another member of our Comp Northwest senior leadership team, Vice Dean and National Osteopathic Physician Leader, and my respected colleague, Dr. John Pham, who will be talking about the significance of the white coat. I've known Dr. Pham for more than 20 years. First, when he was a medical student in medical school, just like you. Then when he was chief resident, and finally as a practicing physician. When we began this journey that became Comp Northwest and has now become WesternU Oregon, Dr. Pham was amongst the initial team that gave up their practices, as did I, and took on the challenge of training the next generation of physician. Giving up your practice is a huge sacrifice, and Dr. Pham, when given the opportunity to do so, felt that there was a greater calling and that he had an opportunity to make an even bigger difference by becoming part of educating the next generation of physician. Along the way, he has become a local, a state, and a national leader. He has been nationally recognized for his work with pre-medical programs, the pre-med program that many of you were involved with. He's been recognized as a national mentor of the year, and he's held leadership roles across the state, including being president of the Northwest Osteopathic Medical Foundation. He is a tireless champion of our students and is our Comp Northwest Vice Dean. Please welcome Dr. Pham.
Well, 20 years, I'm only 32 years old. President Wilson, Board of Trustees, Provost Guchuk, Dean Crone, faculty staff, the community, and our students, thank you for this opportunity to be your Vice Dean at Comp Northwest. Today, I have the privilege of welcoming all of you as we celebrate the beginning of a minute's journey for the DO class of 2022. And particularly, I direct my words to this incoming class of student doctors. The white coat that you will wear shortly has been a symbol of healthcare professions for generations.
Many physicians have worn this coat, and wearing it is a privilege bestowed upon all those who earn a place in the healing arts. With great privilege also comes great responsibilities to your future patients, to your profession, and to your community. You all represent the glowing flame of the future of osteopathic medicine in Oregon, our nation, and the world. The white coat is just a symbol, but it's a powerful symbol that marks the transition from being a pre-med to join the long tradition of outstanding osteopathic physicians. The white coat is a symbol that to you and to others that you have been invited to walk this path with many years of training ahead of you. The white coat is just the beginning, signaling your acceptance of the rights, roles, and sacred responsibilities of being a physician. It's a symbol of your commitment to a lifetime of service, learning, growth, leadership, adventure, joy, and discovery. It also symbolizes professionalism, caring, and trust, which you must earn from your future patients. Today, you'll be coded by your faculty who will one day become your peers. Some of you will be coded by your parents who are physicians. As you, DO class of 2022, entering the College of Osteopathic Medicine of the Pacific Northwest, we celebrate your bright future and your pretty smiles for another week. Okay. We recognize the journey that you will travel is long, full of individual and family sacrifices, requiring great courage and perseverance as you strive to attain your goal of becoming a fully trained osteopathic physician. Everyone in this room here is here to support you in one way or another, and we all have your best interests at heart. Medical professionals, community service groups, community individuals, faculty and staff, your new extended family welcomes you and wishes you well. No one here believes that the journey will be an easy one. It's not easy to get to this point, and you'll work harder than you ever will to meet your ultimate goal, and that is to become an osteopathic physician. Our admissions team has carefully chosen you from a field, as everybody said, 4,000 people. We selected 4,000, out of 4,000 we accepted you 107. That is an accomplishment. So we should celebrate you. We feel that you most closely represent the sort of people who will become outstanding physicians. We will hold you to high standards. We will support you as you progress your education and training, and we will celebrate your success. Today, you will receive your student doctor white coat and your first physician bag. These are both meaningful symbols of a future that you have chosen. Treat them with pride and respect. Your white coat and your medical bags are gifts from the Osteopathic Physician and Surgeons of Oregon members and the community supporters. We welcome and honor you as you embark on your medical career to join the community of physicians. President Wilson, Dean Crone, with your permission, we would like to coat these future bright physicians.
Will our students please stand and come to the stage to receive your first white coat?
Nirusha Abedira, Northridge, California.
Christina Ajin Kim, Olympia, Washington.
Alec Ajar, Canadensis, Pennsylvania.
Rory King, Salem, Oregon.
Alexis Amatisto, Springfield, Oregon.
Austin Client, Lebanon, Oregon.
Hannah Killian, Boulder, Colorado.
Valentina Kucher, Salem, Oregon.
Mary Kirby, Centennial, Colorado.
Emily Lawrence, Bend, Oregon.
Sophia Jones, Puyallup, Washington.
Ashlyn Lawson, Camdenton, Missouri.
Chris Ingram, Utah County, Utah.
Nathan Levitt, Springfield, Oregon.
Justin Blaskowski, Grand Junction, Colorado.
Kunwoo Lee, Claremont, California.
Andy Boyer, Kalispell, Montana.
Michael Lethine, Portland, Oregon.
Rebecca Bracken, Barrington, Rhode Island.
Fengxing Jane Lee, Westminster, Colorado.
Matt Birmingham, Bellingham, Washington.
Gabrielle Nicole Lujan, Redlands, California.
Josh Bezekny, Golden, Colorado.
Tyler Madison, Vail, Colorado.
Talia Barnes, Albany, Oregon.
William Cooper Proctor Maloney, Sebastopol, California.
Brittany Banfer, San Diego, California.
Ashley McRoberts, Alpine, Utah.
AJ Breen, Oak Grove, Minnesota.
Nathan Milojevic, Beaverton, Oregon. Angelo Brennan, Portland, Oregon.
Elizabeth Moore, Portland, Oregon.
Samantha Brennan, St. Cloud, Minnesota.
Mackenzie Murphy, Yamhill, Oregon.
Katie Beter, Boulder, Colorado.
And the Song Club, Pomona, California.
Lillian Burroughs, Seattle, Washington.
Whitley Nelson, Lebanon, Oregon.
Daniel Carter, Forest Grove, Oregon.
Huang Feng, Patricia Nguyen, Tigard, Oregon.
Gabrielle Chang, Coeur d'Alene, Idaho.
Sierra Nicole, Honolulu, Hawaii.
Sahil Chavla, Vancouver, Washington.
Nicholas Sanseri, Bend, Oregon.
Joni Chow, Pasadena, California.
Holly Russell, Everett, Washington.
Emily Sue Cloward, Layton, Utah.
Sean Phillips, Eugene, Oregon.
Monica Coward, Seattle, Washington.
Zeke Perks, Bellingham, Washington.
Andrew Cox, Littleton, Colorado.
Vicky Pengshou, Happy Valley, Oregon.
William Crowley, Ashland, Oregon.
Marcus Pearson, Grand Forks, North Dakota.
Ashley Curran, Plymouth, Massachusetts.
Romil Patel, Glenview, Illinois.
Bridget Dahlberg, Boston, Massachusetts.
Christine Park, Chicago, Illinois.
Alexandra Dalton, Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Kira O'Driscoll, Reno, Nevada.
Dayton Dean, McKinleyville, California.
Kaylinda Tran, Chino Hills, California.
Dana DeCrieff, Twin Falls, Idaho.
Amanda Tepp, Portland, Oregon.
Ariana Enzering, Davis, California.
Kevin Strawn, Spokane, Washington.
Julia Fisher, Hillsboro, Oregon.
Kyle Still, Portland, Oregon.
Heidi DeWong, Westminster, California.
Tori Starzik, Poughkeepsie, New York.
Mario Godini, Eugene, Oregon.
Zachary Smith, Marysville, Washington.
Rachel Gantz, Waukesha, Wisconsin.
Lucas Short, Roseburg, Oregon.
Cameron Garvin, Graham, Washington.
Philip Shera, Eugene, Oregon.
Justin Harris, Sublimity, Oregon.
Darian Mulberry, Philomath, Oregon.
Connor Hendricks, Sherwood, Oregon.
Irene Young, Los Angeles, California.
Lisa Huynh, Happy Valley, Oregon.
Wendy Wu, Montebello, California.
Alicia Harrington, Colville, Washington.
Jane Wong, Kirkland, Washington.
Hubba Haynes, Winchester, Virginia.
Nathan Weston, Washougal, Washington.
Chandler Genetazio, Waynesville, Ohio.
Bryn Walsh, Portland, Oregon.
Stephen Gay, Orem, Utah.
Alexa Viniotis, Bellevue, Washington.
Elise Tran, Reno, Nevada.
Hallie Burley, Olympia, Washington.
Jesse Herman, Palmer, Alaska.
Bryce Civic, Phoenix, Arizona.
Jeff Kerr, Whitefish Bay, Wisconsin.
Preston Danielson, DuPont, Washington.
Kavya Mandy, Portland, Oregon.
Aaron DeGraw, Ogden, Utah.
Mary Adele Meehan, Boring, Oregon.
Jessica Shen, Delray Beach, Florida.
Jan Oy, Amarillo, Texas.
Luke Smith, Norfolk, Nebraska.
Nicholas Wing Sing Wu, Tacoma, Washington.
Audrey Taylor, Roseburg, Oregon.
Kevin Alex Zinneker, Munich, Germany.
Jasmine Townsley, Pendleton, Oregon.
It's now my pleasure to introduce our speaker for the Pledge of Commitment. Dr. David Danielson is a graduate of the WesternU Comp Class of 1999. He completed a residency in diagnostic radiology at Mattigan Army Medical Center. In 2005, he was deployed to Baghdad in support of our military operations in the region. He is currently a lieutenant colonel in the U.S. Army Reserves and remains on the teaching staff at Joint Base Lewis-McChord, where he has trained over 80 radiology residents. He's been married for 25 years to his wife, Colette, and they are proud parents of 6 children, including one in this class of 2022. Today, Dr. Danielson is administrating our Pledge of Commitment.
Will the class of 2022 please rise? You'll now need to open your program to page 10. Please repeat after me the Pledge of Commitment. As I embark upon my studies at Western University of Health Sciences, I will enter into a relationship of mutual respect with my professors and my colleagues. To enhance the learning environment and to gain the knowledge, skills, and attitudes of a competent and compassionate healthcare professional. Accept responsibility only for those matters for which I am competent. Maintain the trust and expected of a healthcare professional. And never take advantage of the relationship I have with my patients. Show compassion and respect for all others. Set worthy examples in the application of humanistic principles. In my relationships with patients and others within the healthcare community. Work toward improving my sensitivity and skills. In human interaction, understanding, and respecting the differences among my patients and colleagues. Value the knowledge and wisdom of the healthcare professionals who have preceded me in the profession. And endeavor to contribute to the humanistic tradition and philosophy. Recognize my weaknesses and strengths. And strive to develop the qualities that will earn the respect of my patients, my colleagues, my family, and myself. Continue learning throughout all the days of my life. Thank you. You may be seated.
Our next speaker is the Western University Executive Student Government Vice President, student Dr. Kaylee Shiraboga. She is originally from the 600-person town of Rockland, Wisconsin, but has been living in the Pacific Northwest for the past 5 years. She received her Bachelor's of Science in General Science and a BA in International Studies with minors in Business and Spanish from Oregon State University. She also received her MBA in Business Analytics from the Oregon State College of Business. She is a second-year student at Comp Northwest and is currently working on several research projects aimed at helping improve the healthcare in local areas, as well as promoting policy change for better advocacy for women in medicine. Please welcome student Dr. Sharaboga.
Well, hi, everybody. As Dean Crone just said, my name is Kaylee Chiriboga, and I am the SGA voice today. But before I begin, I would like to thank President Wilson and Dean Crone and all of the esteemed dignitaries up here for their endless work and devotion to our university. Without these people, our education would not be possible. I would also like to thank our Lebanon community members, the families here, and my fellow students for their constant love, support, and passion. All of this helps us enter the healthcare field ready to help those that need us most. So I want to thank you all, because not one person would be here today without all of those people. So can I ask for a small round of applause for everybody? Well, class of 2022, I want to welcome you to Comp Northwest. I know that this week has been exhausting, but I hope you've already begun to learn my favorite part of what it means to be a community member at Comp Northwest: family. We truly are a family here, and I want you to know that any one of your classmates ahead of you, including myself, are here for you. We have gained insights from our own experiences and are eager to share what we have learned with you. Honestly, even when I sat down to write this speech, I thought of all of the topics I could discuss. I thought of previous speeches that I've heard that have motivated me or inspired me, and I thought about the speech I heard when I was sitting in the very same seats you're sitting in today. And I thought back, and of all the speakers that I have listened to in my past, the ones that remained with me are ones that told true stories of their own struggles and how they got through them. So bear with me, but I want to share a story with you today about my biggest struggle in my first year in medical school. And that story began sitting in your very same seats. I remember feeling extremely nervous, nervous and a little anxious about what was to come. I knew no one around me, but I had already made one judgment upon them, that they were all incredibly smart and intelligent people. And yet, I left one person out of that judgment, and that person was myself. I felt very different from the people around me. I'm really not the most conventional medical student. I'm the first of my family to go into medical school, and I truly had no idea of what I was getting into. So this is imposter syndrome, guys. It's something that's going to happen to you, each one of you, at least once during your medical school career. It's the feeling of not belonging where you are today in the thoughts that we managed to trick the system, or maybe you don't deserve to be here. And I didn't know it at the time, but from day one, I was experiencing imposter syndrome. And as I sat there in your seats, I thought to myself, all right, Kaylee, you're in it now. You just got to do it. Maybe if I just keep my head down, I'll make it through this journey called medical school. A journey of which I had heard so much about. I had heard of the endless studying. I have heard of the lack of any sort of life outside of all of that studying. And I have heard of the drinking from the fire hose metaphor that was mentioned earlier. However, if you haven't guessed it with me standing here today, I didn't kind of keep my head down and only study. I got a little bit more involved. I didn't follow the thoughts that I had a year ago. I didn't try to be like everyone else around me and just not draw attention to myself. I learned very quickly that to thrive in this marathon of a journey, I needed to stay true to who I am. I learned that I needed to believe what I stood up for and search for answers when I wasn't content with the first explanation I found. I also learned that most times, I was my own greatest obstacle. And when I realized what made me different was a strength instead of a weakness, that's when I truly found my stride in medical school. Therefore, I want to tell anyone in the audience today that was feeling at all like I was, you do indeed belong here, and you can do it. You've worked so hard to get to where you are today, and you have an entire support system of fellow students, administrators, professors, and physicians here at Comp Northwest to help you along this journey. This support system, or family as we often refer to ourselves, will be here through the crazy ride that is your first year of medical school. For me, it was one of the most challenging yet rewarding years of my life. There are going to be days when you see your first optic disc in your physical exam, and there are going to be days when you finally get that grade in that really difficult class that you've been trying so hard to get. However, there's also going to be days when you feel like you've sunk to the bottom, that you feel really defeated because maybe you failed your first test, very common, by the way. And there are days when you're going to sit there and think, why did I ever think studying for the rest of my life was a good decision to make? However, pushing through these days are what will allow us to grow as a person and as a professional who learns how to get back up after being knocked down, be that by a test, a life matter, or maybe one day, a difficult patient encounter. Therefore, to wrap up my speech in a classic Pacific Northwest fashion, I'm going to end with a mountain climbing metaphor. So, as cliche it sounds, I know, bear with me. You really do have to climb the mountain to enjoy the view at the top. And the medical school mountain is one heck of a climb. However, just as you won't scale a mountain alone, you won't be climbing this one alone either. You will learn to rely on your classmates to get you through when you slip and fall, just as your classmates will learn to rely on you. Yet together, you can scale mountains far greater than those going alone. And that is what we all have the opportunity to do as a part of this community, this family, be that a literal mountain or maybe a mountain of PowerPoint slides. So today, I would like to say welcome to Comp Northwest again, congratulations, and let the climb begin. Thank you.
Our next speaker is Dr. Ginger Cupid, a Comp Northwest graduate of 2017. Dr. Cupid grew up in rural ranching community in southern New Mexico, where she wrestled steers, rodeoed, and explored the expansive outdoors. After high school, she attended Northern Arizona University, where she obtained a Bachelor's of Science in Parks and Recreation Management. Upon graduating, she worked multiple jobs to expand her global perspective, including working as a chemistry teacher, a backpacking guide for troubled youth, a movie stunt double, true, a bus driver in Mexico, a construction foreman, and a global health humanitarian aid worker. From her trips abroad, she found her passion was medicine. During her years at Comp Northwest, Dr. Cupid served as her class president, earning the nickname Hurricane, which was a well-deserved nickname. It was describing her whirlwind of energy and her ideas. The list of her accomplishments as a medical student is long, all of them helping to build our strong Comp Northwest Foundation. You will notice her name plaque by her old study station. All who follow her benefit from her leadership as a student at Comp Northwest and her path building. She is now a second year family medicine resident at Georgetown University and was recently recognized as the intern of the year for Georgetown. Someday, I fully expect she will be president of WesternU. She's going to skip right over being dean. Please welcome Dr. Cupid as our alumni speaker.
Greetings. Thank you. I'm incredibly honored and humbled to be here among you and to speak on behalf of the Alumni Association. Thank you so much for having me. To Lebanon and Comp Northwest, it's good to be home. I've missed you dearly. To the class of 2022, welcome. I'm grateful that you've decided to take a leap and to join us here at Comp Northwest. I promise you, you will not regret this decision. As of today, you're officially part of our Comp Northwest community, or what I like to call our Comp Northwest tribe. And our tribe is a force to be reckoned with. We are fiercely supportive, graciously understanding, and exceedingly ambitious in becoming a safe and cohesive community. We're also a tribe dedicated to knowledge, compassion, patient advocacy, teamwork, and most importantly, becoming a vibrant, highly skilled physician. As in most tribes, there is a ceremony that takes place to celebrate and to honor new members. Typically, there is a gift to mark their new place amongst the tribe. Additionally, there is an exchange of wisdom from one generation to the next to grow the legacy of the tribe. Today commemorates our celebration of you. For your induction, your gift is the short white coat. It will serve you well in identifying your status as a newly minted medical professional. Every physician before you has worn one. I did, but so did Dr. Pham, Dr. Junkins, even Dean Crone and President Wilson. They too sported their waist-trimmed jackets with their pockets full of knickknacks as they went through their medical training. And now they're here leading the way for the rest of us. And one day, that might be one of you. Now to impart some wisdom to help you navigate your path towards success and to encourage you to partake in our Comp Northwest legacy. One thing you must know, Comp Northwest by itself, it's just a brick building. It's the people inside that make it a legacy. So let's make this into a legacy we are all proud and honored to be a part of. So my wisdom for you, during your medical endeavors, at some point, you are going to fail. That's right, you will fail. But guess what? Everyone fails. And I truly mean everyone. There is no shame in failing. Every great before you has had their taste of failures. It is a bitter, awful taste, but one that we must endure to improve. But the good news is, you can and you will handle it. Maybe some of you may fail to score that A you were aiming for, or fail to place that lumbar puncture after the first, second, or even third time. Or maybe you will simply fail to pay your bills on time, to remember to shower appropriately, or to even remember your wedding anniversary. The people behind me know this truth. We've all failed. I can't tell you how many times I've failed. But remember, greatness takes failure, because your greatness is built on your ability to get back up, to know your limitations, and to know when to ask for help. And it is these key measures that will set you apart. Just don't fail more than our student guidebook allows. Also along your journey, you'll be tempted to lose your humanity. You may scoff now and think, that will never happen to me. And hopefully that will be the case. But for a portion of you, you've never been pushed like you're about to in the upcoming years. You are constantly being bombarded with new information. Everything is going in with little opportunity to give out. And when you get too full, you start losing a piece of yourself to make more space. And when this happens, this is what I like to call the constipated medical student. To avoid this grim diagnosis, you need to take time to take care of yourself, to ground yourself, because no one will take care of you better than you. You are your best investment. So in order to invest in your growth and to prevent yourself from bursting, find a mentor, someone to be your pillar of strength when you need it. Also, find an outlet to pour yourself into, whether that's getting involved in a club, a sport, a religious group, or even calling home to talk to a dear friend. Do whatever it is you need to do to unclog. Find your ultimate enema. This past February, I found myself in a hard place, despite a very successful year in residency. After working shift after shift, neglecting my sleep debt, and avoiding my work emotions, it all began taking a toll. Things around me started to appear gray. It wasn't until I verbally snapped at a poor medical student for nothing to wake me up. Their pain was instant, and I saw it reflected back to me in their eyes. I knew then and there I'd become the Tin Man with no heart from the Wizard of Oz. Things needed to change. I immediately apologized and then made it a goal to find strength of character again, just as WesternU had taught me. So I started to invest in those around me and myself, and I began pursuing avenues that connected me to my passions. With time and process, my character started reforming again. Right now, I want you to take a moment. I want you to recall that day Dr. Pham called you, or that email to declare your acceptance into Comp Northwest. Do you remember how you felt? How joyous and excited you were? Now take that memory and store it deep within, and don't let it go. There is a reason you wanted to go to medical school. So when you feel as though you're walking around in the dark, find this memory. Let it be your light to guide you through. As you develop yourself along your journey, remember to take care of your tribe. My classmates, they were remarkable people with incredible depths of character. Near the end of my first year in medical school, I had a very terrible week. Within days of each other, one of the people who meant the world to me passed away unexpectedly. And then shortly thereafter, my dad was in an accident and placed in the ICU. In those tragic moments, my tribe took care of me. It was Kendall who found me a way home, and Mia who tutored me so I wouldn't fall behind. And then there was Josh with his big, sincere heart who kept me in check of what was truly important that week. You're going to find people like this. Comm Northwest intentionally looks for people of that caliber. And it's the relationships you build here that will help sustain you and breathe life into you. So look around you. These are the people who are going to be there for you, sharing their notes with you, laughing at your corny jokes, celebrating with you as you conquer another exam, and then standing shoulder to shoulder with you when life hits hard. And lastly, glance at the people on the stage. They're your tribe too. I've never met a group more dedicated and zealous for their students than the people behind me. Get to know them. Their support for you knows no bounds. So believe in each other, support each other. You each are worth believing and investing in. Out of all the things I mentioned today, I want you to remember this one key point. Medical school is what you make of it. I personally had an immensely rewarding experience. Now, that's not to say it wasn't occasionally painful with its long, tedious hours and its 1,000 exams, but overall, I love this place. I love my class and the people behind me. I know love is a gushy verb, typically not used in the professional setting, but there's no other word that better describes my time here and with these people. It was the place I felt safe, valued, connected, and pushed to become a better version of myself. If that doesn't entice you to get involved and to take control of your medical school experience, maybe research will. There's a tremendous amount of data out there that supports the connection between being involved and academic success. The studies I read demonstrate that the more you were involved academically, whether it was through curricular or extracurricular activities, the better academically they did, as well as felt happier and had gained more resiliency. So the moral of the story, get involved. Take control of your medical school experience. WesternU will provide you the tools to thrive, but you will determine your outcome here. 4 years will go by very quickly, so learn as much as you can, make some lifelong friends, and have a blast along the way. So welcome to our Comp Northwest tribe. We, your colleagues, your tribe members of the past and future, are in this together with you. We believe in you, support you, and embrace you for the singular way you'll add to our program and to your future patients. Together, you'll accomplish great things as students, but one day you'll go forth and do outstanding things as alumni. Good luck, and thank you.
Class of 2022, each of you received a black medical bag today. This medical bag not only serves as a symbol of your profession, but also as a commitment to your future patients. Members of our local communities, as well as supporters from around the state, generously purchased each bag. Let it be a reminder of your responsibility to your community and any future community you serve. Carry it with pride and with appreciation. Class of 22, please stand and pick up your black bags. And it has become our tradition, raise these bags ahead of you. Thank you, you may be seated. Mr. President, it is my pleasure to present to you your Western University of Health Sciences College of Osteopathic Medicine at the Pacific Northwest
Class of 2022.
Thank you, Dean Crone, and congratulations to our new incoming students. As we look to the future, I want to remind everyone that each of you is going to become a healer who treats one person at a time, but in aggregate will have in your hands the lives and wellness of thousands. So let me say, always remember your gift to your patients is yourself. Your hands, your mind, but most of all, your heart. Our hope is that after you have completed your education here at WesternU, you will be ambassadors of the healing arts and of this university. I know you will go forth with skilled hands and compassionate hearts to help the world become a better place. Finally, I ask that all of us recognize none of us succeeds alone. We have all had a lot of help to get where we are today. There are parents, grandparents, husbands, wives, partners, children, friends, who've been there for us and helped us to get to this point. So I would like them to stand and be recognized. I would also like to personally recognize my wife, Sandy, who has been at my side for 46 years, since we were 15 years old, and if you can believe it, I had flowing blonde hair. So please stand, the families and friends. I thank you all for your wonderful, warm participation in this great event today. And again, I welcome the students to the WesternU family. And I now declare the academic year in session.
Ladies and gentlemen, for those who are able, please stand and remain at your seats until the recessional is fully complete.